This is how we do it. And welcome to Intern Confessions.
Intern Confessions.
It's
both. It's a mixture. However we
just
feel.
Just when I thought I said, we can't say that because, you know, we might get sued.
It goes by our feeling, how we feel that day.
We have to be careful with a lot of stuff we do in here because most of the time we could get sued.
We don't got money to get sued.
We really don't. Not yet.
I have no money in my bank account right now.
Well, see, the way that my bank account is set up, I have all my money is in the future.
Yeah.
But it's coming.
So you got me ready in the future? You got my back? That's right.
So, Intern Diary.
Yeah. All right, I see how it is.
No. But no, so we're doing our confessions about the whole, all the secrets of Studio A.
I hope we have a lot of secrets. So now you're in the club. You're about to be in the club.
You about to be up in this jump.
Let's talk about sex featuring Alexis Gibson and the fabulous Gloria Connie. Woo woo.
Let's talk about sex.
I like that too. Hello, I'm Alexis Gibson, also known as Lexi G. And today we are doing our segments called the Intern Diaries. So today we have different types of interviews that we're going to talk about. Today I have Ms. Gloria Coney here with me. She's the host of Sex for Her Health and Happiness. Yes. So I want to make it known that this show, sex is such a taboo subject that people act like they don't want to talk about it. But the thing is, the reality is that our young people today, 12, 13-year-olds, are actually having sex unprotected, and they're not ready for the responsibilities that come out of it. You know, babies is the least of their worries. They can actually catch AIDS, herpes, all kinds of STDs. So I have Ms. Gloria here so that we can clarify what we can do to protect ourselves, because we're going to have sex. Best thing to do is just know what to do and how to prevent it. So she actually gave me a list here about different types of myths, and she gave me a quiz. I don't know how I did on it, but she gave me a quiz and a whole bunch of questions that she thinks is really important for us to know. So how are you doing today, Ms. Gloria?
I'm doing fine, and thank you so very much for inviting me.
Thank you.
If I may add one thing to your intro.
Sure.
You mentioned young kids. Mm-hmm. You'll be surprised how many older women believe in these myths. And also, women, African-American women, 50 and up, are contacting AIDS more than any other group in this country.
Really?
And they're getting it from black men. White women are tending more to get it from the needle. Mm-hmm. But black women, 50 and up, are catching it from black males.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's kind of scary now that I'm sitting here thinking about it. Like, that's really scary.
Yeah, you go into all of the senior places where they have programs and all, on the table where they have the announcements of plays and things like that, there would be a bowl full of condoms.
They did that in university too, in my college. They would just like throw condoms at us and just make sure we practice safe sex. But I also heard, I don't know if this is true, but I heard in Florida, there's a place that's full of senior citizens that have AIDS because they don't have safe sex. Did you hear about that?
Yeah, and right here in Boston, it's the same thing.
Really?
Across the country, senior women, older black women are coming down with AIDS.
Wow.
And so that means that they're contacting it within the last 5 years. It wasn't that they got it when they were a teenager. Mm-hmm. It's in their later years.
That makes me scared to have sex when I'm old.
No, when you get old, you'll know. yeah. how to protect yourself.
Hello. Ow, yes. Yeah. Uh-huh. Well, let's get to some of these myths, because some of these are actually crazy, and I've actually heard of some of these. So the first question is, you can use plastic wrap or balloon, ew, if you don't have a condom. Is that
okay, true? Now, the answer to that, you know, we laugh when we hear things like that.
Right.
But a lot of women and men believe it will is true, mm-hmm. and it's not true. No. They don't fit well, and they can easily be torn doing sex. So,
like,
yeah.
That's gross, mm-hmm. putting that stuff in your toots. That's not hot. So the next question, actually the next myth is, I won't get pregnant if I urinate right after sex.
Okay. And, you know, I've heard that throughout the years.
Yeah.
And many women, young women, believe that today, mm-hmm. and older women. Right. But no, it's not true. Urinating after sex will not stop semen and sperm that have already entered the uterus through the cervix.
So, but my question is to you. If you urinate after sex, what would that do? Like, what is that? Is that like a way of cleaning, or no?
It's
just gross.
No, no. Urinating is urinating. You're and.
And they're not ready for the responsibilities that come out of it. You know, babies is the least of their worries. They usually catch AIDS.
We can't hear them.
Young people, say 12 or 13 year olds, are actually having sex. Responsibilities of it. You know, babies are there. Can actually AIDS, herpes, all kinds of STDs. I have so can what we can do to protect ourselves. Best.
Doing sex.
you're about to be.
About to be. That makes me scared to have sex when I'm old.
No, when you know.
It's just
out.
could get s-
ready in the future? You got my back?
And the fabulous.
Oh. Like on FG. The host of Sex, Her Health, and Half. Yes. So I want to make it known that this show, Sex, she gave me
women, African American women.
Use plum.
Semen and
would that do? We might get
fired that day.
We have to be careful with a lot of stuff we do in here because we could get sued.
We don't got money to get sued.
We really don't. Not sure.
I have no money in my bank account right now.
Well, see, the way my bank account is set up, yeah. I have all my money is in the future.
Host X.
How many women? to that. About the years.
For her happiness. Yeah. So, you know, they don't want to talk about it. But the thing is, the reality is that our young people, 12, 15-year-olds, really worried.
down.
And they're not ready out of it. You know, babies is the least of them.
To your senior. I don't know if it's the same thing. Got it when